Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In this video, we are going to dive into DaVinci Resolve 20 and one of the controversial new features, I think, and it is the ability to do voice training of AI. And, well, like it or hate it, it's in DaVinci, and let's try it out. So maybe I'll just try to see if I can learn the neural engine inside of DaVinci Resolve to AI generate my own voice. I think that's what we're trying to do in this video anyway. So I'll try to see if I can show you how to set it up and if it's any good, because that's what we're going to test out in this video. So without further ado, let's jump into the world of AI voice training.
Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and we're going to create a AI voice model, which is one of the new features in DaVinci Resolve 20. And the way we are doing that is we need to give the AI model something to work with. And one thing that's different than other AI voice generation models in DaVinci is actually all of the material is on your computer, so it's not going out to the cloud. So all of the data and stuff will be on your local computer or hard drive. So let's create my own voice. In this case, that's what we're going to do. So I have here a, you need to give it like 10 minutes to work with. I have here like 36 minutes of me talking, different tutorials put together. So let's train the AI now. And the way we are doing that is we're going to go up to the media pool here. And I have the clip right here. So I'm going to right click and I'll go into AI tools. And then I have DaVinci Resolve AI Voice Trainer. And if it doesn't work, you actually need to go up here, DaVinci Resolve and extra download. And then you can download the voice trainer right here. I did download it, so. Okay, so right click on the clip, AI tools, and go into AI voice trainer. And then this is pretty important. Please do not steal anybody's voice. It's not a nice thing to do. Don't take some famous person and generate their voice because it's easy to get their voice samples from them. Please don't. And don't take my voice either. This is the paralegals. I'm giving my own permission to use my own voice. So let's accept that. And we're going to get this new pop-up menu here. So I'm going to call this Klaus ENG. And I think I'll try to do a Danish version, but that's later in this video, I think. So I'm going to go into the training accuracy. And I'm going to change this into better. It is on better. If I change it to faster, it will go slightly faster. But we're going to use some time on this. So let's just click start. It will begin to do its thing. And this may take a while. So I will be back whenever it's done. This is going to take like 5 hours or something. Maybe I'll be back whenever this is done. So I'm just quickly back. So when it has prepared your video, this pop-up menu will be right here. And it's now doing the basic work, and you can actually see down here you have this new icon down here, and that's just to tell you that it's doing this. And you can now do whatever you want in DaVinci Resolve. I can click here and I can see the process of what it's doing. Again, this might take some time, so I'll be back whenever it's done. Okay, so now DaVinci Resolve has done all of the voice training on the AI model, and it took quite a while. It was around 8 hours of learning, but let's check it out. So we're going to take this clip here from a Blackmagic video. This is the trainer Chris, and we're going to take his voice and replace that with mine. So let's just have a listen to Chris.
I'm Chris. I'm an editor and a Blackmagic certified master trainer.
So let's say that we want to change his lovely voice to my voice, and we're going to do that just by right-clicking here on the clip, and then we go up to voice convert. So here we have voice convert. And first off, we are going to decide which track we are going to put our new voice in. And just for easiness, we're going to put this on audio track 2. We're going to go down here to the voice model. And of course, we could use the female voices and that, but that's not the point of this video. I have here my voice. And for now, I'm just going to push render. So now it's going to listen to the voice, and the thing is, it's going to match up the movements of the mouth as well, which is kind of cool. And yeah, let's just, I'm just going to mute Chris, and then we can hear it with my voice.
Hi, I'm Chris. I'm an editor and a Blackmagic certified master trainer. And today we're going to look.
So one thing, it is pretty specific on accents. So Chris is obviously from Australia or something, and I am not. So it's going to take some of the words and stuff like that. But pretty cool, I think. So if we want to have another voice, I'm just going to unmute this clip here, and I'm going to take Chris, and I'm going to change it into one of the pre-made ones. So let's take it into, so let's go in and take this male US, and I'm going to put this on track number 3, and I'm going to render it, and there we go. So I'm just going to mute the tracks, and let's have a listen.
I'm an editor and a Blackmagic certified master trainer. And today we're going to look at multi-camera editing in DaVinci Resolve.
So now you have the ability to use the original voice, use your own, or use one of the pre-made ones by Blackmagic. Kind of fun. So to test this further out, I did do another voice model as well. This time I did a 10-minute voice sample in Danish. So I want to see if it's actually doing a good job of that, and it's actually running now in the background. In about 2 hours and 55 minutes, I will know if it's doing a good job. The good thing about this is that the magic of editing, I can just make a cut and the 2 hours would be done by now. So let's jump to the Danish test. Okay, so the time has passed and we are now going to test out the Danish AI model I created with my own voice. So for this video here, we are going to use this little example here from the killer snails I did a couple of years ago. We're just going to change my friend Thomas's voice into my voice, which is going to make this a very strange scene, me talking to myself, I guess. So let's just have a quick listen to the voice of Thomas.
Du Jens?
Yeah?
De der dræbersnegle, der har været noget snak om, hvad det egentlig, de dræber?
So that is the voice we're going to change. So first off, I'm going to highlight Thomas's voice, right click and go up to voice convert. I'm going to get this menu up here and I'm going to put this into audio track 3. And I'm going to take this one I did, Klaus DK, and I'm just going to push render. So it will do its thing. Obviously it's pretty fast here on my system. And then I'll just mute the Thomas track and let's have a listen.
Du Jens?
Ja?
De der dræbersnegle har været med snak om, hvad er det egentlig, de dræber?
De dræber alt.
Kan man ikke gøre noget?
So I think it worked out pretty well. Danish is a hard language for anybody to learn, even AI. I think over time this will be better. This is still in beta, so I think it's pretty cool. Actually, just for the fun of it, I actually took the same clip yet again and thought, what would happen if I took the exact same thing here and did the same thing, but instead of using a Danish voice, I would use one of the pre-built ones. So let's take the female US and let's render that. How would that actually work? Can that actually do Danish? I wonder. Let's just render the thing and figure out. So again, I'm going to mute Thomas and let's run the track clip.
Du Jens?
Yeah.
So yeah, a little bit stupid, I know, but kind of funny. Well, anyway, that was all for this video. I do hope you found this kind of content useful. If you do, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's another video here at the channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.